an announcement. Gentle request to please keep yourself muted. We are going live. A very good morning to all the dignitaries and my dear student friends. I, Tejaswini Shevate, Assistant Professor in Commerce, welcomes you on behalf of Symbiosis College of Arts and Commerce to the day 4 of the Student Induction Program organized by Team Deeksharambh under the UGC Guidelines. Before we begin, a short review of the previous 3 days. We took you around the college virtually through Know Your College. We got more information about Honours Program, the Liberal Arts with BCom, Integrated Disciplinary Program, Center for Skill Development, Center for Innovation and Entrepreneurship. We got to know more about the CIMA, Chartered Institute of Management Accountant, and ACCA programs. Yesterday, we had a wonderful interaction with our principal, Dr. Soman Sir, as well. We went through the evaluation and credit system by the exam department. We also had 2 experts with us, Dr. Vivek Sane Sir and Dr. Shirish Limaye Sir, who guided us on industry dynamics and skill sets needed post-pandemic and instilling human values and becoming responsible citizens. I hope the sessions were inspiring and insightful. Hoping to continue with the same zeal and enthusiasm, we begin day 4 with presentation on NSS, that is National Service Scheme, by our very own dynamic and enthusiastic Dr. Santosh Marwadikumbhar sir. It is rightly said by Mahatma Gandhi, the best way to find yourself is to lose yourself in the service of others. Indeed, service is a fulfilling activity in one's life, and each one of us should be involved in such a service scheme. Dr. Santosh Sir is an assistant professor in the Department of Accountancy since July 2011. He is in charge of National Service Scheme NSS department since March 2019. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Tejaswini ma'am. At the outside, let me thank Deeksharambh Student Induction Program Committee for giving me this opportunity to introduce NSS program. Today in this session of 10 minutes, I will let you know about NSS scheme, NSS scheme at national level, NSS scheme at university level, and NSS scheme at our college. So I have made a small presentation. Let me share it. Hope you can see it.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, as I said, I'll present 3 things. 1, national service scheme at national level, and national service scheme at our college. Basically, national service scheme has been playing a vital role in enriching the souls and minds of the students since long time. The overall objective of this scheme is education and service to the community and by the community. It is a program for students to cater to the needs of the community as and when required. It also helps the students to communicate with the society. The students joining this scheme develop many behavioral interactive skills. The motto of the NSS scheme is "Not me, but you." Reflects the essence of democratic living and upholds the need for selfless service. NSS helps the students to develop appreciation to other person's point of view and also show consideration to other living beings. The philosophy of the NSS is well doctrined in this motto, which underlines on the belief that the welfare of an individual is ultimately dependent on the welfare of the society on the whole, and therefore the NSS volunteers shall strive for the well-being of the society. The National Service Scheme is an Indian government-sponsored public service program conducted by the Department of Youth Affairs and Sports of the Government of India, popularly known as NSS. The scheme was launched in 1969, aimed at developing students' personality through community service. NSS is a voluntarily voluntary association of young people in colleges, universities, working for a campus community linkage. The cardinal principle of the NSS program is that it is organized by the students themselves, and both students and teachers, through their combined participation in community service, get a sense of involvement in the task of nation building. It would have been impossible to effectively run a program directly from the Union Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports, dealing with the over 29,000 educational institutions across the country. The implementation of NSS program has been possible due to effective collaboration and partnership between the colleges and state universities. NSS is a liberal education scheme is developed for development of the personality of students through community service. It is a student-centered program in which projects are implemented by the NSS volunteers in the community in close collaboration with the community, and thereby it provides vast scope for the students' interaction with the people. Students, you know, develops, understand the community in which they work. They understand themselves in relation to their community. They identify the needs and problems of the community and get involved in problem solving. They develop among themselves a sense of social and civic responsibility. They utilize their knowledge in finding practical solution to individual community problem. They develop competency required for group living and sharing of responsibilities. They gain skills in mobilizing community participation. They acquire leadership qualities and democratic attitudes. They develop capacity to meet emergencies and natural disasters and practice national integration and social harmony. Regular activities includes functional literacy and non-formal education. Tree plantation, preservation and upkeeping of trees, construction and repairs of roads, cleaning of village, ponds and wells, construction of, laying of parks, health education, primary health education, first aid awareness, blood donation, anti-drug addiction drives, advocating advanced agricultural practices, relief and rehabilitation, disaster management, women empowerment, road safety, campaigning against social evils, creating awareness about flagship programs of the government like Digital India, Skill India, promotion of yoga, socio-economic surveys, improvement of campus. NSS at our college, we are having a center of 200 students, and you will have to be volunteer for 2 years. In these 2 years, you will have to complete 120 hours in a year, and you will have to participate in a special winter camp, which will be of 7 days. The NSS unit organizes activities like, at our center, winter camp, community services, camp work, campus work, celebration of national days, tree plantation, blood donation, awareness program, assistance to the authorities in rescue, relief and rehabilitation. Let me introduce our NSS department. Myself, Dr. Santosh Marwadikumbhar, NSS in charge. We are having a program officer, Dr. Sharavi ma'am, and program officer, Nilesh Varmare, sir. This year we are planning to form Green Army students group. So we are going to conduct a survey of villages to find out the issues and problems. At rural level, we will be having a survey, research survey. I had talked with the university representatives, the director of NSS department, and I had told him that we'll be having a survey to find out the rural problems. We'll be preparing a research report and will be forwarded to the university authorities and later on to the government. We are planning to have the campaign to spread digital literacy, financial literacy. For students, we will be organizing value education workshops. Of course, health awareness campaigns will be organized. Now, what are the benefits to the NSS volunteers? If you are a NSS volunteer, registered volunteer, and if you have completed 2 years of NSS regular activities, then you will get certificate from Savitribai Phule Pune University. Then you will have to participate in at least one winter special camp, which will be organized for 7 days. We organize various activities, workshops, contests. So if you participate, certainly you will get awards and certificates at university level, national level and state level. Students, those who have registered, they would get 10 to 15 grace marks as per the Ordinance 163. What it states, what are the terms and conditions of this ordinance? We'll be having a separate meeting on this, how you can get 10 to 15 marks. Then you must, got to notice that we have introduced one value addition credit. Those who, registered as NSS volunteers, they can avail one NSS value addition credit also. And what work supposed to be done by the NSS volunteer, where they are supposed to get involved, these things will be again shared in a separate meeting which will be scheduled. Once you get registered, then you will get to know about the value addition credit and grace marks. I'll just show you a few activities which we had conducted in academic year 2019-2020. We had participated in Guinness World Record. So this is our group of students participated in Guinness World Record. Then we had distributed food items to the workers. Those who are from Pune and Maharashtra, they must be knowing about workers. The blood donation drive, students participated, around 39 students participated in blood donation campaign. Then inauguration of NSS program. Then, we had organized many lectures like yoga and its importance, then cyber crime, then we provided food items to the donated to the Kolhapur flood victims. Road safety awareness drive was conducted over our campus, tree plantation. Okay, you will get to know that what are the activities which we conduct at our college. These days are celebrated. We had special winter camp in 1920, and in this academic year, previous academic year, we couldn't organize activities because of offline, colleges were closed. In EY, I had instructed the students to join various NGOs, and at their level they have done few work, like students participated as a COVID warrior, volunteered blood donation campaign. They had donated blood also, mask and sanitizer distributed, then food distribution made by the students, awareness program about the government schemes. This is a registration form for the new NSS volunteers. You can click a snapshot. Then we are having NSS Google Classroom also. Class code. You can copy it. Okay. We have formed a Telegram group. We are not having any WhatsApp group. Telegram group is formed. This is the link to join NSS group. So, hum yuva hai, hum kare mushkilo kisse samna, rashtra hi jage hai hamari kamna. Thanks. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Sharavi ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you, Santosh sir, for your thoughtful information. We will now move on to the next presentation. I believe sports is the art of life. It gives meaning to our lives. So our next presentation is about our sports department and National Cadet Corps, NCC, by our very own Aniruddha Sharma sir. A sports teacher with dynamic personality and leadership qualities, we'll be taking you through our sports department and college achievements in sports. I know many of you must be interested in this. Over to you, sir.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Firstly, I would like to thank the team Deeksharambh and student induction team to give me this opportunity to speak and introduce students to what sport and how the sports in college is followed. So thank you so much. Now I would start my presentation. Is it visible, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Firstly, our college is affiliated to Savitribai Phule Pune University. So we do participate only in the matches which are organized by Savitribai Phule Pune University, in the intercollegiate events and interzonal and inter-university events. So what is the list of events in which the college does participate? So we'll go through that. So see, this is a list of, these are the 32 games in which college does participate. This is a list of the 32 games. You can read it out and find your game which you like, means which you are professionally playing or want to participate. These are the list of games which our college does participates in both men and women categories. Next, I would like to show how to participate in this. So how do we do? At the beginning of the year, we get a schedule from the university of the matches. So we display an yearly calendar in our college, which has the details and dates of what tournament would be conducted in which month, tentative month. We get a detail of the month, in which month it would be conducted. And the same yearly calendar is displayed outside Gymkhana, and there are more two locations in the college. So you can get to know these things more when the college actually physically reopens, but then you can actually see these things. So after the calendar is displayed, what do we do also at the beginning of the year? We have every student who are interested to participate in sport register themselves through Google Form. Google Form link is shared at that time on the college website. Under General Notices tab, the Google Form is shared for participation or registering in the sport activity. So after the yearly calendar displayed, registration is done, again a notice is displayed for team selection. So prior 15 days, 1 month prior to the tournament, a notice is displayed that, suppose take for an example, table tennis tournament is after 15, 20 days. So we display a notice, we book a venue, and over there we have to go and conduct selection trials. So interested students have to come and appear for the selection trials, get selected in the team. After they get selected in the team, then you have to complete your eligibility for participation. University requires eligibility for participation in intercollege or any tournaments affiliated to the university. So we have to complete the eligibility. We have to fill the registration form, which we call for eligibility, on time. And only after that, the players can participate in that sport. So this is what is followed for intercollege. And next, once you fill the eligibility, you can again go ahead with participating in an interzonal and inter-university if you get selected ahead. Next, we also conduct physical education exam. So this is a compulsory exam for everyone, for every student who is studying in first year BA and first year BCom, ACCA, interdisciplinary, everyone. For everyone, first year students, it is compulsory. So what is the format for the exam? For semester one, we conduct lectures. Lectures is compulsory. Attendance for the lecture is compulsory. And after that, MCQ is conducted. And after you pass the exam, you get one credit. This exam is also compulsory and also a credit course for you. Two credit you get in two semesters. In second semester, if we go, we have practical exam. We conduct physical fitness tests. We have three physical fitness tests. We do conduct physical fitness tests for everyone. And there are passing criteria. This is difficult for many people, but yes, there is no option for it. Then you have to do project writing. You have to select any sport and you have to write few information about the sport. And that is been given 25 marks. And after successfully completing and passing this, you get one credit into it. Please, students, note this, that this is a compulsory thing and you have no way out of it. Next, what do we else have? We have registered a Symbiosis Fit India Club. So what do we do in this? What our main motive is? Our main motive is we have to spread the awareness of physical activity and physical fitness amongst all the students or all the people in our college. So we do have different activities done by them. We have physical fitness challenges. We have physical fitness activity. We have different tasks going on for the students. Currently, as of now, the Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav walk and run challenge is going on. It will be ending on 2nd of October. So if you are not yet done, you just go through the college website. There is a notice displayed on the college website. Check the details and start participating if anyone is interested. But I say that that is a good activity and everyone can participate and has to participate for yourself only. It would be good for all. This club is open for all. Everyone can come. Anyone can register. Only they have to be a college student. They can participate in this. Registration will be done through Google Forms. I'll be sending a Google Form link again for the same on the college website. And sooner you can register and then you can participate in activity. Also, if any students wish to be a part of the organization team, they can surely turn up, get in touch with me, and participate as an work as an organizer or in this part. Next, you get additional marks for participating in sports and NCC. So what is it? So for participating in if you participate in interzonal tournaments organized by the Pune University, interzonal tournaments is after intercollege tournament. What you get benefit, I'll tell you later on, but interzonals, you have to participate and you get additional five marks if you participate in any interzonal tournaments. At the end of the year, for getting marks, only after participation you don't get any marks. You have to come and submit your certificates, fill out the Ordinance 163 form, and only after that the marks are allotted and displayed on your mark sheets. The additional marks will be displayed on your mark sheet. Next, participation in state level, inter-university, West Zone, All India Inter-University Sports Tournaments. In any of these tournaments, if you participate, if any students participate in any of these tournaments, state level, inter-university, West Zone, All India, you get 10 marks, additional 10 marks in your mark sheet. Then if you get a medal, if you get a gold, bronze, or silver or bronze medal in All India Inter-University Sports Tournament, you can get 15 marks, additional 15 marks for participating in this, for getting, for your achievement. Also, every student has to make a note that you can take a benefit of only one of these above. Suppose a person is getting a medal in All India Inter-University, you cannot come and say that I have also done interzonal, I have also done West Zone, I have also done All India. So you cannot get all these things. The best one would be allotted to you. Additional marks for NCC. NCC, what it is that you have to complete 75% parades out of the total number of parades, and one CATC camp, annual training camp. You have to complete that, and only after that you get 5 marks for it. Then National Integration Camp, National Thal Sena Camp, RD Camp, conducted in New Delhi, Army Attachment Camp. All these camps, if you do, you get 10 marks for it. And if you are doing both of these things above the above condition, you get 15 marks for it. NCC also, I would like to mention that for NCC, our college does not have an NCC unit. So for that, you will have to go and visit the NCC headquarters, which is exactly next to our college. Ask for an open unit, whichever wing you want to go, Army, Navy, Air Force, whichever wing you want to go. You have to ask for an open unit, get the physical fitness test done by them. They conduct the test. After that, if you pass the test, then you are allowed to enter it, and then you can come and ask the college for the no objection from. Enroll yourself. Next, credits. This is the most important part for students these days. So getting credits for participating in sports and NCC. So what is it? Firstly, I'll go to intercollege sports. If you are participating in intercollege, and you give almost 60 hours for practice, training, and everything, you get one credit for that. Means participating in intercollege and giving 60 hours, you get one credit. Then training, coaching at a professional level. This is the students who are playing at a professional level, who are an international, national level athlete. These people do train at a professional level. So these people spend most of their time playing on the field. So for them, if they have spent the time, 45 to 60 hours, probably the hourly calculation is done for them, and they can get a credit for that upon depending on the number of hours which you are spending. So for this, what the student has to do is they have to keep a track of the training. You have to keep a schedule of the training. You have to keep a track that every day, how many number of hours what you're training. And at the end, you have to get a letter from the academy which you are training, that what number of hours you have spent, and the detailing, the track which you are keeping with you, that has to be submitted along with that for getting credits. Then participating in invitational tournaments. Invitational tournaments, if you participate in any 3 invitational tournaments, there are many invitational tournaments conducted by different colleges, different clubs in and around Pune. So if our college team goes and participates in these invitational tournaments, if you participate in any 3 invitational tournaments in that respective academic year, you get one credit for that, for 3 tournaments. Next, adventure sport. If you do any course in related to adventure sport, if you do any adventure activity in that, if you have the proof of that, if you are submitting everything properly, documents, you can get 1 to 3 credits for that. Then if you complete your Scout and Guide, Red Cross, self-defense courses, if you complete these courses, you can get again 2 to 3 credits for that. For NCC parade, anything in NCC, if you are completing daily parade, either you can get the benefit of marks or you can avail the credits. Only one of the that is allowed. Only one thing can be availed. Only one thing can be availed. Then fitness, sport, Zumba, yoga course, any of these courses, if you are completing any of these courses related to fitness, related to sports, related to Zumba, related to aerobics, so you can get and credit for the course depending on the number of hours and calculation which will be done by us. Again, state, national, international tournaments. These tournaments, again, the same thing, Ordinance 163, you have not taken any benefit in that, you want credits. That is decided by you, that if you want ordinance for that, you want grace marks for that, or you want credits for that. Anything can be availed, whatever you want. Again, 1 to 3 credits can be given for this participation in state, national and international tournaments. Next, I would like to show you a small video. I'm pretty sure this video must have been, you must have been got to know that what sport is and why do you play sport. This is a very motivating video and I do very much like that video. So I thought I would share that with you. Next, if you have any queries related to from this presentation or any other queries related to sports and anything, you can surely drop me a mail. My email address is displayed on the screen. You can anytime come and see me in college gymkhana, but this is only after the college actually physically reopens. Also, we do have a group on Telegram. You can just search for SCSE sports and you can join the Telegram group for our college. So over there also you can get in touch with me. You can talk and you can ask any queries which you have and it will be solved out. So that's it from my end. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sharma sir. I would now warmly welcome Mrs. Monica Parikh, faculty and in charge, BCom with ACCA, BCom integrated with CIMA and international initiatives. Ma'am has more than 12 years of teaching experience. She is a qualified cost accountant and also a ACCA affiliate. She will be guiding us on the international initiatives undertaken by our college. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Tejaswini. I would like to thank Dr. Shariyu Bakri, ma'am, and team Deeksharambh for giving this opportunity to tell the students about international initiatives. I would like to start my presentation. Yeah. Is my presentation visible, Tejaswini?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. A very warm welcome to all my dear students to this introductory session on international initiatives today. For every educational institution, there is a purpose, and Symbiosis too has a truly unique purpose. Just a moment, please. Set up to take care of the international students studying in India and to provide them with a home away from home, the Symbiosis International Cultural Center was established in 1971. Our founder director, Dr. S.B. Muzumdar, believed that education is the best medium to inculcate international understanding amongst the students. He hoped that Symbiosis students would become the ambassadors of goodwill for our country. He envisaged a multicultural campus where students from different parts of the world would study together, live together, and play together. Even today, he believes that Symbiosis students serve the world well by going back to their countries and fulfilling their potential of being true ambassadors of goodwill. We are under Savitribai Phule Pune University and have students from approximately 36 Afro-Asian countries. All these students learn an appreciation of tolerance of different cultures. Symbiosis, the motto is Vasudeva Kutumbakam, which means the world is one family. Our campus, like every other campus of Symbiosis, promotes international understanding through quality education. Symbiosis promotes both outbound and inbound international exchange programs to add an additional perspective to this vision of quality education. Here at Symbiosis College of Arts and Commerce, the team members for international initiatives comprises of Dr. Rishikesh Soman, our principal, sir; Dr. Tessie Tharadil, our vice principal, ma'am; Dr. Hilda David, head of liberal arts; Dr. Ginny Jacob, Mrs. Sarika Wagh, and myself, Mrs. Monica Parikh. The objectives of international initiatives can be summarized as to conduct joint research projects, increase the cultural awareness, student exchange program, faculty exchange program, exposure to different curriculum and pedagogies, study abroad programs, and equipping the students to become global citizens. The activities can be categorized into outbound, inbound, as well as collaborations. The first outbound activity that we have is a semester exchange program with Hildesheim University, Germany. Hildesheim University offers more than 40 plus graduate and master's programs under psychology, language, cultural studies, creative writing, environmental science, to name a few. Our students have been going there for the semester exchange program and have learned a lot about the culture, gained self-confidence, improved their language skills, and made new friends for life. The Erasmus Plus offers you support during your period of study abroad. A liberal arts student who has studied German is eligible for this semester exchange program. We also have a MOU with Kedge Business School, where the machinery is in place for seamless admission for the master's program in Kedge Business School, France. This institute has campuses in various locations in France. We have students who have enrolled and graduated from the master's program from this institute. We also have faculty exchange program, as you can see here. Our principal, Dr. Soman, Dr. Suneni Pachuri ma'am, Dr. Hilda David ma'am, Dr. Tessie Tharadil have conducted sessions in the Hildesheim University. We also have Dr. Sharayu Bakre ma'am, Mrs. Sarika ma'am at Kedge Business School. Dr. Aarti Vani ma'am, head of English department, presented a paper in Georgetown University in Washington, D.C. We have Dr. Shirish Lemeser, who presented a paper in Oxford University, and our Alpana Vaidya ma'am, head of psychology department, participated in the international conference in Japan. Coming to the inbound programs, we have hosted scholars and residents, guest faculty, and keynote speakers from different countries on various occasions. We had participation from many faculties from different countries in our international conferences. We also have faculties coming from different countries and conducting sessions for our students. This session from Kutztown University, conducted by Ms. Dr. Anita Mayhem, was just conducted yesterday for the psychology student. There was active participation from the students of Department of Psychology. We also have sessions organized for our foreign students. One such program is the Make a Difference, that is MAD, where cultural exchange takes place. These students also participate and take up social projects like the one you see in this picture, where the students are engrossed in revamping a bus stop near our college. This helps them to reach out to the local community and understand them better. Students from different countries also conduct workshops for our students here. You can see here a Korean workshop was conducted, as well as Amazing Africa, a workshop was conducted for our students here. Coming together is beginning. Working together is progress, and staying together is success. We also take up activities with institutions abroad. Recently, we had a buddy program for the Japanese students from the Kanda Gaigo and the Chiba University. Our very own Dr. Zakira Sheikh, a multi-talented faculty, conducted a session for the Japanese student, introducing them to India, diversity, and multiculturalism. Our Symbiosis College of Arts and Commerce students acted as their buddies and helped them to understand about India, its history, and rich culture. We also conducted a workshop on intercultural aspects of information literacy along with Hildesheim University. Our Vice Principal Ma'am, Dr. Tessie Tharathil, conducted this workshop along with faculties from different countries like Bosnia, Germany, USA, and India. Last but not the least, we also have an exchange program with students from France. We have partnerships with two colleges in two different locations in France. The French students are hosted by our students when they visit Pune, and similarly, when our students visit France, they are hosted by these French students. 15 students from our college went to France and were hosted by them in May 2019. As our Prime Minister says, internationalization of higher education promotes sharing of the best academic and research practices through interactions between diverse education systems and helps in developing global citizens through mobility of students and scholars. It has altered every conceivable aspect of our life, including higher education. As you can see, the pandemic and the travel restrictions has not curbed our enthusiasm. We at Symbiosis College of Arts and Commerce are very eager to reach out to the various institutions abroad and live up to our motto of Vasudeva Kutumbakam. For further queries, you can contact me on monica.parikh@symbiosiscollege.edu. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Monica, ma'am. I would like to announce that we will now take a short break of 5 minutes. Let us meet at 11:25. A polite request to all you students, we will be sharing the feedback form for today, day 4. You are requested to fill the same towards the last half an hour. See you back at 11:25.
On this student induction program, it is a pleasure to invite our alumni Abhinandan Chavan and Nandini Dev. It not only provides an opportunity to connect, but at the same time is nostalgic. It is such an honor to welcome our alumni who have established themselves to such a successful and laudable heights and have made us proud. Through the College Alumni Committee, the college has been in a constant touch with our illustrious alumni. Now, I am privileged to introduce Abhinandan Chavan, who has excelled and distinguished himself in the corporate sector. Abhinandan Chavan has done his graduation from Symbiosis College of Arts and Commerce. He has completed his MBA in finance from Pune University. He has been awarded I Am Exceptional Award by EY in 2020. Best Student of Symbiosis under the Center of Innovation and Entrepreneurship in academic year 2015-16. First ENY Scholar from Pune 2015, one of only 9 across India to be titled as Future Leaders by EY LLP. He has even been awarded Principal's Special Recognition Award for Exceptional Extracurriculum Activities in 2014-15. Currently, he is working as an Assistant Manager Consulting Quality Team at ENY LLP. Over to you, Abhinandan.
Thank you, Alka ma'am. Good morning, students, teachers, and everyone who's present on this call. First of all, I would like to thank my Symbiosis family for giving me this opportunity and inviting me for this student interaction. And a very special thanks to my guru, my mentor, who has always been my guiding light from the day I joined Symbiosis till today, Dr. Sharavi Bhakre ma'am. So let me, Sharavi ma'am reached out to me some time ago and said that we are having this induction session for the first year students, and I would like you to share your journey, because it has been an unexpected journey. You know, we never imagined, no one in fact imagined, that I would be able to do somewhat what I have been able to do till now. So if for an average student, or I must say a below average student, if Symbiosis, this turning point of my life, can do so much, imagine you guys are just fresh talent, and this 2-3 years of your Symbiosis you can utilize to make maximum out of it. So let me just share my screen and we can start. Yes. Can you see my screen? Can someone confirm if it is clearly visible?
Yes.
Perfect. Okay, so as ma'am has given my introduction, I am Abhinandan Chavan. I currently work as an assistant manager in consulting quality team, which manages the quality and risk of EY in India. I am an MBA finance and Symbiosis alumnus. So the beginning of my journey was, I was about to become a Symbiosis dropout. So my journey name I've given is to be Symbiosis dropout to the best student of entrepreneurship. How this circle of life completed, the circle of Symbiosis, I must say, completed, I will just give you a glimpse of that journey. As Steve Jobs has rightly said, that you cannot connect the dots looking forward, but you can only connect them looking backwards. As we discuss and go through my journey, you will see that every step, everything which happened in college was in some way preparing me for the next level or the next step throughout these 3 years, and it has been the same case till now. So I must say, from the time I started my 11th standard till today, everything is just, I can see and connect the dots that this happened, that is the reason the next step happened, and that is the reason I am where I am today. So very few people know that there was a Bachelor of Computer Science in BCS in Symbiosis, Senapati Bapat Road, and I was a student there. Due to some financial problems, I am working since my 11th standard. I used to work as a salesman. I used to stand on streets and sell induction cooking machines. That was a new thing that time in India when I was in 11th, and participated in various Sakal shopping festival where I used to stay in full day and explain people how the machine works. And I used to get 300 rupees per day for selling that machine. Slowly, by the time I did my 11th and 12th, I started working as a business development executive in an IT company, which was working in US business. So I used to work in the night and the BCS college was during the day. Now BCS is very difficult course. It had practicals in the morning at 8 a.m. and the curriculum was as difficult as an engineering, and it started becoming really difficult to manage the night shift and the studies, and I was constantly struggling and falling back at my studies. And that is when I had to decide that this is not something what I want to do, and I cannot quit my job because of the financial problems, and I had to sponsor my education as well. I had some loan so I had to pay back that loan. So I decided to quit my BCS, and that is when BCS also, it was the last year of BCS in Symbiosis. So next year there was no BCS because it was not under the autonomous accreditation. So I decided to join BCom from Symbiosis. I met Vice Principal Parchure ma'am, and then we shifted from my admission from BCS after completing 3 years. Okay, this was 3 years into BCS, and then I shifted to first year of BCom. So this was a big setback in my journey, and I was back to ground zero when I started FI BCom. So after FI BCom, I never attended college in the first year because I was working, and BCom was 2-3 hours which I could manage with my work, and it was going really well. And that is when we had to do the choice of specialization. What should I take? Should I take marketing, because I always was fond of marketing, or finance, or entrepreneurship, which was the new thing which Symbiosis had introduced that time. Then I discussed with the fellow entrepreneurs who I was working with. I was working in a startup that time. So Gurmeet Singh, he suggested me that these all things are normal, but this entrepreneurship thing, I'm not sure how these people are planning to teach entrepreneurship in college, because entrepreneurship cannot be taught in college. It is how you learn it. It is a journey of an entrepreneur. But that was a very curious part. Hence, I joined entrepreneurship as a specialization. And that was the turning point of my life. That is where it all began. First year went without any college attendance. I just came for exams and presentations. Second year, every time I used to meet Sharma ma'am used to say that, Abhinandan, you should come to college. There are so many activities which are happening. Just the way your sports teacher explained, or international events are explained. Same way Sharma ma'am used to explain me that these are the activities which are happening in college and you're missing it. And I never took her seriously. That no, because I my job is my priority and I cannot come regularly to the college. Hence, I ignored her for some time. But later, I started attending these events, and they were very interesting, learning from the stories of the entrepreneurs, the guest lectures. It started becoming more and more interesting, the college. That is when I got to know there is this scholarship, which is known as EY scholarship. It is a business plan competition, and it will be a national level event where top 10 colleges, every college will have this competition, and 10 people from every college will be, every city will be selected as EY scholars, who will be titled as the future leaders. So I thought, everyone thought that because I have corporate experience and I have been working since a long time, by that time, I have better chance compared to all other students to win. And I understood business pretty well. I was a sales guy and I could speak good. So I designed a business plan, which was a basic car wash business case, and submitted it on the last day. That too, EY had followed up that we did not receive your business case, and I prepared it whole night and submitted it midnight, just before the deadline. And after some days, top 10 were announced, and I was surprised that my presentation was one of the top 10 selected, and later in top 3. And the top 3 presentations were to be presented in front of the EY partners, who are very qualified and experienced people in business, and you have to convince them to win that competition. The day of competition came and my name was announced the first person to present at the competition. Because of the experience, because I of the sales experience, I had very little stage fear that time, and I went ahead, gave my presentation, and everyone was stunned the way the presentation was. As soon as I came down, all my friends said that this was really good, though I thought it was not up to the mark, but this was really good and I won the competition. That is when EY awarded me 1 lakh rupees scholarship and a 2 months internship with EY. That 1 lakh rupees was so important for me that time that I repaid all my debts. I could quit my job and sponsor my education and completely focus on the Symbiosis BCom. That is when second year I quit my job and started focusing on college. Slowly, as Sharma ma'am was mentoring all of us, and she saw the spark in us, my entire group and my all my friends circle, we were into organizing small events in college. So we were the core organizing team of entrepreneurship. We organized under guidance of ma'am, we organized Dharavi visit, where we learned so many leather manufacturing techniques, and we always thought Dharavi is a slum area, but we never knew it is a business empire in itself, which was a very good learning. Then we went to Fratelli Vineyard, how the entire wine industry works, and from grapes, how the entire process works, which we saw. We went to Malinagar sugar plantation and distillery. We saw how the sugar is getting prepared from the molasses, how distillery functions, how ethanol is prepared, which is used for blending in petrol. And after all this, the wastage is converted into electricity. It was such an integrated experience, the Malinagar sugar plantation experience, that we never thought that so many simple things come together to bring in this wide range of businesses. My engineering friends were always jealous. They used to tell me, Abhinandan, we are not experiencing so many industrial visits in engineering that you are experiencing in BCom. So we are just jealous of you, the way you are learning. And these were the things Symbiosis was teaching us entrepreneurship. Using the academics, which is a very strong part of Symbiosis, no doubt, but giving actual experience where it matters, because education cannot be in just 4 walls, classrooms. This is what the team perfectly understood, and they were the perfect people to take this entrepreneurship to next level and impart it into education. We also met the founder of Goli Vada Pav that time, whose talk and whose conference was really inspirational for all of us young aspiring entrepreneurs that time. And then later we also worked on 1 Symbipreneur's book, which was the collection of interviews of all the entrepreneurs who are alumni of Symbiosis. So all these events were preparing us for the next mega event, which is Spandan, which was the mega event of entrepreneurship. We organized Spandan. It was a social entrepreneurship event, which was a huge success that time. This is all in second year. For this event and all the other events which were organized, we were awarded Principal Special Recognition Award. Me, Anuj, Shishti, we were some of the people, some of the team members under guidance of ma'am, we got this award. And this gave us a big boost. Now, all these awards, Spandan, and all these experiences, they were building us for something bigger, larger than life, which was waiting for us ahead in the next year, which was the third crucial year of our college. And that was Symagine 16. Symagine used to happen in Symbiosis on a very normal scale, which was a college, inter-college fest, where 2-3 events used to happen. And we always saw Symbo and Simples, which are the mega events of Symbiosis with bigger campuses, bigger sponsorships. And we always envied that why can't we, Symbiosis College of Arts and Commerce students, do this? We even discussed this with Principal Dr. Soman. Dr. Soman said that there are people from big entrepreneurship groups which are studying in SLS Law College or Simples. But SCSE is a regular college. We have the regular crowd from middle class. We will not be able to pull up this such a big level event. But the team and I had decided that no, we have dreamt of this event on a grander scale, as grand as Simples, and we will be able to pull it up. We had many challenges. First challenge was the biggest of all. As they said, entrepreneurs are the engines that drive the world, and financing is the fuel that propels them. To propel us to that level of Simples and Symbov, we needed huge amounts of money, and our college was not that kind of a college which will have huge surplus money which they could invest in an event, because we were academics focused college. So we had to raise this sponsorship from scratch from all the businesses around. With such a small campus compared to the other big Symbiosis campuses, it was a big challenge. But we finally could do it. We got Airtel as a title sponsor. Definitely the Symbiosis brand was the major asset which we had. So we could get that sponsorship from Airtel, 3.5 lakh rupees Airtel gave, and total sponsorship which we could raise was around 8 lakh rupees from small businesses and small stall owners. And we invited an artist from Tomorrowland, which was a very big thing, which even Simba and Simple struggled that time, to that SCSE campus, and it was a big, huge success in the third year. After this, for my entire contribution to Symagine 16, to Symbiosis through various events, and all the things which I could do in Symbiosis, I was awarded as the best student of entrepreneurship, which I could have never imagined I would ever be, because there were so many talented students along with me. The team was so talented that I was nowhere compared to them in academics as well as in other extracurricular activities. But these things slowly made me a better person in itself. And because of these experiences, I was subconsciously getting groomed to become a leader. In this Symagine, I had to lead 200 people's team, 200 student volunteers, to manage that entire event, which had more than 100 small events and 10-15 mega events. So it was a big success and big achievement. I still consider it one of the most important achievements in my life on such a grand scale. And this is where my Symbiosis BCom journey was completed. The learning was completed. Next is, after this best student award and the success of Symagine, we were on cloud nine. Okay. Everyone knew us. We were the popular kids in the college, and everyone thought that these kids with this experience and good academics would easily be able to crack the placements which are there. So Deloitte was the first company which came for placements, and in this overconfidence, me and my friends, we went to Deloitte for an interview, and we were rejected before we could go to the interview itself. We were in the aptitude exam. We were somewhere bottom five or bottom six, I would say, and that was a big shock. The overconfidence which was built up was all crushed. We were back to ground zero, and then tension started building up that, we always thought that we could easily crack this thing, but corporate is next level game. This is nowhere we are, and we can just can't crack this one exam. How will we succeed in life? That is when we prepared day and night. When we got to know that EY is the next company which will be coming, we downloaded various apps, we discussed with teachers, bought some books, and learned how the aptitude exam can be cracked. We learned it so well that from the bottom 4-5, we were in top 4-5 for EY aptitude exam. There was a percentage given to students in the aptitude exam, and me and 2-3 of my friends, me, Utsav, Anuj, we were in top 10-15 students of that exam, where we were given, so they had criteria. Above 70, they will give the option for tax. Below 70, they will give option for audit. And above 85 or 80, they would give option both. The students can opt for audit as well as tax. And hence we, some of us decided to go for tax and some of us decided to go for audit. I selected tax, US tax in Bangalore. And then we, then that, there my Symbiosis journey ended and I shifted to GDS Bangalore, where again, it was a new thing, finance, US tax, we had no idea. We learned that craft, I was very successful there, got some regular team awards also there, which post which I had to, now that 1 year of tax was enough for me. My family was back in Pune and then I had to shift back to Pune. I tried US tax, no firm was having US taxation that time in Pune. So I tried shifting to EY India, which is again the prime EY firm, different from EY GDS, to Pune into my current team, which is the quality and risk management team. I came to quality and risk management team. My work involves reviewing a lot of documents, okay? Reviewing a lot of documents, reviewing all the engagement letters with EY. And I saw people, they were so good at it that I can't beat the masters at their game. So I had to invent some new rules, how I can succeed in doing this thing. So first thing was I had to do MBA finance along with my job, which I had done earlier during my graduation. And I was confident that, okay, same way I could manage MBA as well, which again, EY supported me. I had weekend colleges. This was a full-time course in AIBM Institute, where we used to attend college for 16 hours during the weekend, eight hours, and sometimes online. And during this lockdown period, we attended mostly online. I could manage my EY work and the college and completed my MBA finance. Now, everyone was working in Excel, which is the standard format to do things, which I also use most of the time. But we had to do something different. I had to do something different to be highlighted from the team. So I learned this. I got to know about this new tool, which is Microsoft Power BI. And EY has tie up with Udemy, where we could go and learn any technology, any tool which we want, and EY will pay for that course. So I started learning Microsoft Power BI, developed a dashboard, leadership dashboard, which the leadership can see and analyze what all things are going on across India in one single frame. So that dashboard was a big success again. And that is how I cracked that I cannot be super fast or super efficient at the core work, which everyone is, there is heavy competition. I had to do something differently. And this is when I learned about this new tool and implemented it. So I would want all the students to identify that you cannot, competition is very fierce, okay? Everyone has marks, everyone is intelligent now, everyone has technology. It is how you use it, use that technology to just be a slightly better than everyone else. You have to be different than the crowd to succeed nowadays. You cannot be the part of rat race and think that, okay, I will be successful in future. You have to do something different. Power BI was a big success. And now everyone started learning Power BI in the team. And I was awarded IIM Exceptional Award for this dashboard, which is the first award in our team. Someone has got this award. It's a prestigious thing in EY to get this one. And after this award, everyone started learning Power BI because they are now curious that how this works and how to implement it. And now I know that now everyone is in that field. Now I'm learning the next level, which is robotic process automation, RPA, which will where I'm learning how to develop bots, which are small computer robots, which do the redundant task, some tasks which are very simple, which do not require intelligence of human, but which are required to be done. So the bot can be programmed accordingly and he works nonstop continuously on that platform and keep on repeating that work using a UiPath software. So now my next plan is to learn this software and implement it in within our team so that all the redundant work will get reduced and there's something new, you know, to learn. Once this becomes common, I'll have to try something different. So all I want all the students to know is now degree is a base level qualification. Now you need degree, everyone has degree, even bachelor's, even master's. What will differentiate you from the crowd is what technical skills or what different skills you have. Go online, learn new things, be it video editing, be it visual data visualization, be it new softwares. Blockchain is a big thing, cryptocurrency is a big thing. So how to do these things, how do these things work? Try and understand and try and groom yourself in those fields, because these technologies are the future. People who will not develop themselves will become redundant. You've seen, right, how quadcopter works or how the drone works. Within 5 years, the helicopter driver and the cameraman was replaced with a drone and a camera, which everyone can afford. So the people who were stuck there, that okay, I can fly an helicopter and I can shoot from aerial view, they were dependent on that technology, they become redundant. The Kodak is the biggest example how camera technology failed to evolve and digital camera took over the company, and now every mobile has a camera and no one uses those old Kodak films, which caused the destruction of a biggest empire which was indestructible. So I would request all the students to learn these new technologies and adapt. Change is the only thing which is constant and which you have to embrace. So now I will just quickly wrap up my journey with a few tips which I want to give. There are two categories which I have derived: technology based, which is a waste of time, which we all use 90%. Even I use these three tools 90% of my time, okay, which I'm changing slowly. And technologies which are invest in time. So which are your investment, time spent on these technologies, you're investing in yourself, and subconsciously, slowly over the next few years, you will remember that the time which you wasted on these technologies, you could have utilized on the invest technologies. So stop wasting your time on Facebook. Facebook is just for personal friends. They all know you. Showing off on Facebook how amazing your life is not going to help you in future. Okay, TikTok is just waste of time. It is just entertainment purpose. Keep it for entertainment purpose. Same goes with Instagram. But spend more time on LinkedIn. LinkedIn is where you get job nowadays. No one is interested in job portal. No one is interested. No one gets an interview directly. It is 90% of the jobs are getting through LinkedIn. Networking, people get to know what you are. So LinkedIn is a must. Udemy is a blessing. I've shown you, right, how because of Udemy, I'm learning these new skills. Udemy, you can learn anything at what, 100 rupees, 150 rupees. What are the course costs which Udemy has, which you waste on a pizza? You can invest on Udemy and learn some new skill which will differentiate you from the other students because of the competition. You are in Symbiosis. Symbiosis is one of the places where extremely talented people, the cream crowd, will come. So you are competing already in a competitive environment. So please enhance your skills and go to Udemy and try whatever is your passion. Try learning that thing on Udemy, be it photography, be it some coding, be it bitcoins, be it cryptocurrency, anything, just go and learn. Same applies to edX and other online platforms. TED Talks is something which has helped me a lot. I listen to various stories on TED Talks, different people facing different problems which we have never imagined. You don't know what is going on in Uganda or Rwanda and what challenges they are facing, which you get to know through TED Talks. People there are really inspiring, and that is subconsciously we are learning many things using TED Talks. Our own Symbiosis family has arranged so many TED Talks. I was a part of one of the event as I attended that event, and it was such an inspirational TED Talk, which was again organized by Sharma ma'am and her team. It was amazing. So just go attend all the Symbiosis TED events, plus just go and see some TED Talks online, which will be really helpful. Last but not the least, Audible and Google Podcast. Audible is where I read most of my books, listen most of my books while I work out, while I'm trekking. So because we don't have now time for physical reading of books, which is a better way to do things, but in this time crunch, Audible makes it very easy. And Google Podcast. I'm not promoting any apps here. I'm just giving my personal experience that what has helped me, what can help you in future. I think we just have 2 minutes of my time left. My slot was from 11:30 to 12. So if any questions, if anyone has any more queries, we can take this up. Okay, I think there are none. Also, I would request all the students do connect with me on LinkedIn. It will definitely help you. I'll try my best to guide you whenever possible. Whenever I see I see any profile, blank profile also, but I see Symbiosis College of Arts and Commerce, I blindly accept that invite, irrespective of I know that person or no, just because that Symbiosis name, that name has made me what I am today. And I will always try to support you as well because of that name associated with you forever. Thank you.
Thank you, Abhinandan. And we wish you good luck for your future endeavor and ventures.
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome. Now, I would like to introduce Nimisha Dev, who has outshone herself and enchanted the world with her singing skills. Nimisha Dev has graduated from Symbiosis College of Arts and Commerce in 2016. She has been a part of X Factor India, Indian Idol 10 season, and The Voice Top 20. She is a playback singer, and recently she has sung her debut song in Bollywood, the movie One Day. And also she has played playback in a Marathi movie 702 Dikshits, which got nominated in Radio Mirchi Music Award for an upcoming playback singer. She also mentored in Assam's huge reality show Amar Bhupenda Season 5, which was aired on Prague News. She also performed with Bollywood singers like Aditya Narayan, Shan, Ash King, Mohit Chauhan, and many more. She has done more than 1,000 shows around the globe. I would like to share some picture of Nimisha with you all. This is her journey. This is Nimisha with all the classmates at Symbiosis College itself. Over to you, Nimisha.
Hello everyone, I'm Nimisha Dev. I hope you guys can hear me. Okay, so very good morning everyone. No, it's good afternoon, I'm so sorry. Good afternoon everyone, and I hope you guys are safe and healthy. Before I start, I want to thank Sharayu ma'am and Alka ma'am for inviting me here. It's an honor to be a part of this event, and thank you so much for having me here. So I will share a few things with you guys that how I started my journey. I am really nervous right now because I have heard so many good speeches and presentation, and I feel like I didn't do anything right now, but I will try to say few things which actually changed my life, I can say, because I belong from a very small town, Jabalpur, if you guys know. It's in Madhya Pradesh. And being a very, very shy person, I'm a very shy person on these, participating in reality shows or doing playback, it was a big deal for me, because I always used to feel that I am good for nothing, because I was a below average student. And I only used to, think that padhai nahi hoga mujhse. I want to do something different, something out of the box, because I always, believed in myself that I can do something huge. But what, that I don't know. I mean, before, when I was like, pursuing, I was in school that time. So let's start. Okay, so I'll start from Jabalpur journey. I belong from a joint family, and my family is Orthodox, so I was not allowed to go out or to participate in any singing competition or any kind of competition. And for this reason, I was also in a girls' school, because mujhe girls ke alawa aur kuch dikhta bhi nahi tha. So I used to feel that bahar ki duniya kya hai, because I always wanted to explore. I always wanted to do something good. But in my college, definitely I will say she's no more with us. My principal, Sister Rosalyn, she was my guiding angel. And she will always be my godmother. She supported me a lot. So I was in St. Joseph Convent, Jabalpur. And I will say that I was a below average student. So teacher, they used to think that she cannot do anything in her life. They used to demotivate me a lot. And it used to hurt me, because if I'm not good in studies, I can be good in some other things. I was good at sports. I was good at music. I was good at dancing. I was good in, acting also. I used to do few acts also in school time. But I never used to get compliments from teachers. And I remember that I got bullied in school also. I was in class 12th. I remember that girls used to be so jealous of me, because I used to go out for I used to participate in school competition, then few school level competitions or whatever musical competition used to happen before. But they used to taunt me, they used to do something bad with me, and I used to cry. Ek jagah baith ke side mein baith ke, I used to cry and think that why is it happening to me? Am I not worth anything? And the main thing was ki why are they jealous? I mean, and they belong from a very reputed family. Everyone belongs from a very reputed family, but still they used to behave so bad with me. But then I was very depressed. Because I didn't feel like going to school. I told my principal, I shared this only with my principal and my mom, my strongest pillar. I told them that these things are happening with me, and I don't think so I will be able to continue coming to school. And so please, I need your help. I really need your help. It is a very, very important thing. Whatever it is, wherever you are, either in school, college, office, wherever you are, if something is bothering you, you need to talk. You have to talk. So I told my principal about this, and then she said that she will take care of it. She told me that you don't have to come to school, but whatever will be the lectures or all the subject, whatever subject I was homeworks and all, she will let me know. She will give it to me later on. She will guide me, but she will help me, in short. So I felt pretty good, but then my school life was, sab bolte that you know school life should be good, school life it will be a very memorable year of your life, like that. But my school life was not that good, because I always I was there in school just because of my principal, my guiding angel. Okay, so this was about my school. I'm so sorry, I started very depressing, I know, but it's absolutely okay. So in school, when I was in school, I remember it was 2011. I gave an audition for a reality show, which was X Factor, and I didn't even expect it, because I used to give auditions many places, not only in X Factor. There used to be Little Champs, there used to be Saregamapa, but then I used to get reject, because it's okay to get rejection. And but then this day finally happened. I got a call from this team, X Factor team, that you have been selected. So I went to Mumbai. It was a huge thing for me, and I went for audition. It was in Indore, and I didn't know, I mean, that I will be like that reality show will be so huge, and they will, you know, promote me so well. I think that was my first reality show from where my journey actually professionally started. And I was in top 20 that time. And Sonu Nigam, Shreya Ghoshal, Sanjay Leela Bhansali, they were the judges. And before that, a few months back, I will tell you one tragedy also. So before that, before the audition, I had a operation. I had a cyst inside my mouth. So I was very worried regarding this audition, that if I'll be able to perform or not, because I was having, ma'am, just give me a minute. I'm so sorry. Yeah, so I had an operation, so it was like a big deal for me, because I had to perform in few months, and then this thing happened. But anyway, I managed somehow, because it was my dream to perform in front of renowned judges, and being a part of X Factor, like, it's world most famous reality show. So it went really well, and I remember after that audition, when I got rejected, but I got so many appreciation from everyone. I mean, I was in Jabalpur that time. All the media channel used to call me and say ki ma'am, mujhe aapka interview lena hai, kab hum aapka interview le sakte hain. And it used to make me feel so good about myself after a very long time, because after all whatever happened with me in school, and this journey, it actually gave me so much confidence, so much, I mean, it literally drastically changed my life. I was confident, I was brave enough to, you know, accept these things. And when I look back, I see that, you know, I was where I am today. Where are they? I mean, I am doing so much better from those who used to bully me, who used to say bad thing about me. Where are they? I don't even know where are they. So I think I did a really good job by not saying anything, by doing my work and showing them that I am worth a lot. You cannot even imagine. So this was my Jabalpur's journey. Then after my school life, I shifted to Pune, because my mom, she supported me every time. And as I told you before, that I belong from a very orthodox family. So they never used to support me. I mean, they used to support me, but not in like, ठीक है जाओ म्यूजिक करो या तुम्हें जो करना है करो, नॉट लाइक दैट. दे यूज टू बी लाइक, क्या जरूरत है, घर में बैठ के करो, जबलपुर में घर है, वहाँ बैठ के करो. पर आई यूज टू बी लाइक कि I won't listen to you. I want to go to Pune. That means I want to go to Pune. I don't want your suggestion. I'm telling you guys. So, but I wanted to shift to Mumbai because if my career is there, my life is there in Mumbai. So, but my mom was not sure about it. She was like, don't take risk ekdam se. Dheere dheere ek ek karke stairs chado. Ek ek karke apna rasta banao. I was like, makes sense. So, I shifted to Pune. I was staying with my mama, mami. They supported me a lot. I mean, either it's admission, either it's my any competitions in Pune, everything. They made sure that they will take care of me. They used to be like my right and left hand kind of. So when I came to Pune, I was not sure what to do. Because again, I was mentally prepared that I want to pursue in music. But music mein, what can I do? But then slowly I started asking my friends in Pune and my few relatives who had knowledge about these in this field. So they told me to do a graduation. So I was like, yeah, I need to do a graduation. But graduation ke saath, what else I can? Matlab, graduation ke saath, can I pursue my music? Because my main goal was music. So I applied for admission in Symbiosis, and luckily by God's grace I got admission in Symbiosis. It was my mom's dream to be a student of Symbiosis. Whenever we used to come to Pune, whenever we used to come to Pune, she used to see that Symbiosis ka logo and she used to be like, isi college mein tujhe admission dilana hai, isi college mein tujhe jana hai. Aur wo matlab pressure create karte tha mujhe ki college jana hai par kaise, I want to pursue in music. But then, luck by chance ho gaya admission, and I'm so grateful for the entire teacher and all the members, because Symbiosis has changed me in everything. They supported me, though they know that I was not a regular student, but still they used to support me. And I remember the day one when I attended this, I have the certificate also, foundation course, the first day I remember I attended, and I was feeling so nervous because I was a very shy person and I was like, yaar, I don't know anyone, everything is new to me. I was scared, I was shy also, but most of that I was very scared. But then somehow I managed, and first year I was a very I used to attend college regularly, but then second year I was into all the fest which happened, like Symbiosis, Simples, It's Imagine. So I was a part of those fest, so I was not able to attend college that time also. But then teachers used to be like, if you are doing good in music, pursue that. And I was mentally like, but what about my graduation? Because I have to clear my exams. I have to clear whatever it is. I have to pursue my music plus my college. I have to manage college life also. I used to be very confused about these two things, and but then I don't know how it happened. Slowly things have started going very well. My first audition which I gave was in Symbiosis, which was in 2015 again, and it was my first ever competition in Pune, and this is certificate. I came first in Western music solo competition. It was I performed in front of so many good singers and judges, and it was a really life changing moment for me. And then that day only I performed in Symbiosis, Again, I won the competition. It was for Sufi singing competition. So it was really big deal for me. So after winning all the competitions in Pune, I thought, why not I start my musical career from Pune, which was a bit difficult for me though, but still, I mean, I thought that to, you know, I used to go to some, I mean, visit. There was, I remember I went to Amanora and there was this band performing. And I was like, I want to have a band in Pune so that, you know, at least I will start doing my shows and let's start my music career, from Pune only. So I knew few of my friends in Symbiosis. So, and I saw them performing also in few fest and all that. So I contacted them. I told them that, you know, why let's form a band, because you know, there are a lot of competitions coming on like Malhar and then many more. So I told them and they were also very excited to form a band. So we started doing jamming and all, you know, we used to write a song, we used to compose, we used to record it. Then we used to see that if it's worth it or not. Then we started pitching ourselves in all the, you know, colleges, college fest and other studios also. We used to work in studio also. So we were very lucky that it worked. And this was our first competition. No, it was our second competition. Spardha. We won this competition and it was a battle band. It was a rock band competition. So we won that competition and then we went to IIIT Powai. Then we came to Mumbai for a Radio Mirchi show. And then we performed in Mumbai also. Few cafes are there. We performed there also. So it was going really, really well. And then after my graduation, I thought that, you know, now I am prepared to shift to Mumbai, because I, by that time, I already had many contacts with me to, you know, to shift to Mumbai. But it was a really, really big change for me, because obviously it's my dream city. And there are so many people in Mumbai, you know. First thing, whenever I ask my friend that what you don't like about Mumbai, they say a lot of people, they're always running, always running. So it actually scared me also. When I first shifted to Mumbai, I was scared of people, because so tough competition in Mumbai. Everyone is doing something or the other, and you know, I was feeling like, oh my god, Mumbai aa gayi, but what will I do next? Then somehow one of my event manager, I can say, he was my first event manager, he contacted me and he asked me that, where are you nowadays? And I told him that I shifted to Mumbai recently. So send me your profile. I will pitch you for a show in Napur. That was my first show with him. So within an hour, I got a call from him that Nimisha, backpack kar lo, we are leaving tomorrow for a show in Napur. And I was like, what? What just happened? So that was my first show in an event company, and I started doing shows from that onwards. And I remember that was my last day of struggle, I can say, because struggle, I'm saying, using this word, because I believe struggle, I explained my friend also, when people say that you are struggling, you know, bahut struggle hai life mein, I only say one thing, struggle wo karta hai jo jisko pata nahi hai usko kya karna hai. If you know what you have to do in life, you're not struggling. You just have to make your way. You just have to know what you have to do next. So I knew that time that what I have to do next. So I back to back, I used to get a lots of shows. I started paying my rent. That was really, really big deal for me because I used to feel bad when, you know, mama used to give me pocket money and she used to be like, "Theek hai, iska na rent pay kar dena, iska tum ye khareed lena." But I used to say to myself that aisa din kab aayega when I will pay my own rent and I will pay my own bills. And that started in 2017. I used to pay my bills, I used to pay my rent, I used to spend money for myself and for my family, obviously. So it was a really, really proud moment for me. And after a few years, then I started giving auditions also, because that is very important to give audition and to get reject. I know a few of my friends, they used to tell me that, you know, rejection kaise manage karte ho, because sabko एक्सेप्ट जब कर लेता है कोई ऑडिशन में एक्सेप्ट आई मीन आप एक्सेप्ट हो जाते हो सो यू आर लाइक वेरी हैप्पी वेरी यू नो एक्साइटेड कि नेक्स्ट राउंड में ये होगा नेक्स्ट राउंड में ये एक गाना मिलेगा यू हैव टू परफॉर्म इट सो मेनी गुड गुड सिंगर्स बट व्हाट हैपेंड व्हेन यू गेट रिजेक्ट आई हैव गॉट अ लॉट ऑफ रिजेक्शंस इन माई लाइफ अ लॉट एंड इट मतलब Before it used to feel that it's really sad, it's very depressing also. But then that rejection made me a very strong woman right now. And I have, because of the rejection, I've started accepting the fact that rejections are really important in our life. It plays a very important role in our life because you get to know yourself, what you're worth. And I gave auditions in Indian Idol also because it's my dream to perform in Indian Idol's platform. So I started giving auditions in Indian Idol and I never used to get select. I mean, there are lots and lots of competition there, I agree. But after coming to top 50, like till theater round, why I always get rejected in, you know, in final round, like the mega round, I used to feel very bad. But then I didn't give up. I was like, It's okay. Next year I will again give because why not? Then I started giving audition in Saregamapa also. And but my goal was to be a part of Indian Idol. Then it happened on 2018. I was in Indian Idol as Tejaswini ma'am showed you on the screen. That was on 2018. I was still piano round. And it was huge for me. It feels really great, you know, when you're a part of reality show and all the fans are, you know, texting me saying that, you know, ma'am, I'm a big fan. Ma'am, I wish I could meet you in person. And people are asking me to give autograph and all that. It feels really, really good. So after that Indian Idol audition, I was just building my empire, you know, like I made contacts, I made friend in that industry. So I was very confident now ki chalo, now I can do what I like. Ki matlab, if I want to do shows also, or if I want to be a part of reality show also, I know how to do this because I used to ask them ki how it works exactly. So after Indian Idol, I started getting a lot of shows, like many shows. I used to travel everywhere, and I was not even, you know, I was not even getting a break for a day. So I used to travel so much, and I love traveling. I was doing my dream job, I can say. And after that, after you know, shows and all that, I got a call from one of my friend that you know, Nimisha, there is this we want to dub a song, sorry what I'm saying, if you're free then just come to our studio, let's do a dubbing for a movie song. So dubbings are like you will just record that song, particular song, and the other singer or the main singer, she will hear that song and she will do the main song, you know, main song for the movie. But then I was like, all right, why not? Because it was for a Marathi movie. And I was like, chalo, I'll give it a try. But then he told me that, he asked me that, do you know Marathi? I was like, no, I'm a Bengali, so I don't know Marathi, but definitely I can try to sing Marathi song. So I'm talking about this movie. I was in Pune that time, and I had few friends in Pune. So, and I had to record it in Pune only, in a studio. So he told me that, oh, you have to prepare this song by today. I'm like, just give me 2 days at least, because I don't know Marathi and it will take some time to learn. Then he was like, nahi, you have to prepare it by tonight and we'll do a recording tomorrow. So I called up my friend that please meet me ASAP, because I have this recording tomorrow and I have to learn this song by heart and all the pronunciation, because being a Bengali, few words are very tough to pronounce. So they helped me a lot. And the next day when I recorded the song, the music director said that you're gonna be the singer of this song and everyone will listen to your song. And I was like, what? He's like, yeah, you have been selected. You are the main singer of the song. And I was so happy that you guys have no idea. Matlab, it was a very emotional moment for me, because I was not able to accept that. Did I just recorded a song for a movie? And that happened. And that literally changed my life. And after, when I recorded the song, the producer of the movie and the director of the movie, they called me up and they were like, Nimisha, you are chota packet bada dhamaka. I was like, okay, that's a huge compliment from their side. And after recording, everything was going pretty well. And I remember I was in a show. I was coming back from that show. I was in airport that time and I got a message on Messenger congratulations, Nimisha, you have been nominated as an upcoming playback singer for a Marathi movie, Radio Mirchi. It was for a Radio Mirchi award. I didn't believe firstly when I read the message. I was like, hey, this someone is playing a game with me, you know, something is fishy. But then later when I got a call from Radio Mirchi and they were like, hey, congratulations, Nimisha, please send me your address, we want to send you an invitation. I was like, are you guys serious? Am I really got nominated for upcoming playback singer? They were like, yes, Nimisha, the song name was Jin Kun Taku Sari Dunya. And that was the song and got nominated. And I was very, very, very happy. So I stay with my mom in Mumbai. So me and my mom, we went there. We saw this amazing, you know, celebrities over there. Walking in red carpet is a different feeling, I must say, you know. I was feeling like a star. It was my night, I can say, because walking in red carpet, people are taking interview and saying that it's your first nomination, how are you feeling, and all that question which I used to see in TV, you know, that all the Filmfare awards and all that I used to see, and it's happening with me. So it was a really, really big thing for me. And then after a few years, it was 2019, I was doing a lot of shows. 2019, I got a call from The Voice. So The Voice, it's a huge platform. Everyone have heard about The Voice. It's like, you won't be able to see the judges. There is no judges, sorry, there are coaches. So when you have to sing, if they like your song, they will push the button and they will turn around for you, and then you have to do the other procedures. So I was not actually in a mood to give this audition, honestly speaking, because I was already going through, you know, I was already doing very pretty well, touch wood, because I was getting few shows and all that. So I was like, why I need to do this reality show? I won't be able to give time to, you know, myself, because in reality show, you have to only focus on their thing, So I was, I asked my mom that what should I do now? So she told me that let's give it a try. Hua nahi hua, it's okay. You continue with your shows and whatever you do. So I was like, okay, chalo, let's give it a try. So I gave audition and it went really well. And I gave 5 auditions for this. And I've cleared all the auditions. Then the main round happened. So when the main round happened, I was not allowed to do shows that time. So you were staying in hotel in Mumbai only, because they don't allow you to interact with anyone. They don't allow you to meet anyone. When you're part of the any reality show, if you're in top 20, they don't allow you to meet anyone, because obviously agar pehle se dekh liya to fayda kya hai TV mein dekhne ka. So they believe that way. So I was one of the best contestant in The Voice. And I cleared my round. So the first audition where I performed this Kamli song from the movie Dhoom 3, I don't know. I mean, it really one of the biggest life-changing moment for me. Why, I'll tell you. Because after performing the song, Adnan Sami, Kanika Kapoor and Arman Malik, they turned their chair and they selected me. So from three, I mean, there were four coaches, only 3 turned for me. And from that, I need to choose one. So I chose, Arman Malik, because obviously he has so many fan followers. He has so many, you know, good contacts. He's one of the best singers we have in this Bollywood. So I thought that I can learn a lot of things from him. So after that, we had another round, which was battle round. So in battle round, I was with one of the other contestants. And I unfortunately was eliminated from that round because of some reason, not related to music, but because of some reason I got eliminated. The reason was that that's okay, that should be personal. Elimination, everyone, I mean the guru who used to teach me there in the Voice, he was very disappointed. He was like, Nimisha, ho kaise out kar sakto? She was a very strong contestant, so we want her back. And we want her to, you know, come back in through wild card or anything. Just I cannot let her, you know, go like that. So we had a very huge discussion in that. But somehow I was pretty happy that jahan tak journey tha, I was happy, I was satisfied. So I told her that it's okay. And after a few days, I dubbed one song for Hindi movie a few months back, and after a few days from The Voice, I got a call that Nimisha, your song has been finalized for the movie, and that too, it's for a Bollywood movie, One Day, where Anupam Kher and Isha Gupta, they were part of that movie. It's on Netflix also, you guys can watch. I was not able to believe, because it was actually for a Bollywood movie. I mean, I've always dreamt about it and it's happening. So I went to the studio and I recorded the song in front of the director. Now the director was so serious. I mean, he was looking at me when I was recording and I was like, sir, please up mat dekho, because I'm getting very nervous recording this song in front of you. Please just, I mean, do anything, because that was a very, it was a peppy number, and I have to be very happy. I have to be very, you know, I have to dance when I'm recording this song, because it was that kind of a peppy number. And that director was so serious, seriously was sitting and staring at me. I was like, aise record nahi ho payega sir. So I told him, he was like, okay, chill, Namisha, I'll go out. Till then you record the song. And when I recorded the song, he was so happy. And I met all the, you know, actresses. I met Anupam Kher, Isha Gupta, director, producer, the music director of the movie, and they were so happy with my work that I was very, very, you know, happy about that progress. And we had a screening also of this. So it was a really, really good journey till Mumbai, and I'm still I think I'm doing pretty well in this industry, and I'm so proud of it. And playback journey had just started for me. I did few jingles also. I did many recordings for other movies also, but then I got rejected, but other singers are singing those songs. But it's okay, till the time you're in this industry, till the time people are contacting you, that's a really big thing. So I think that I'm really thankful to God for all the teachers in Symbiosis, and my family, everyone, that because of your support, I am able to do so much in life. And Sharayu ma'am, I was a BA student. I specialized in English, and I didn't got chance to to learn from Sharayu ma'am. I was not a part of BCom, so I wish that I was a part of BCom, so that at least I would have got that opportunity to be a part of this college class. So I don't know what I'm saying, I just blabbered something. I'm so sorry, I got lost because all the memories are coming, flashbacks are coming, so I'm getting confused right now. But anyways, I just want to say that thank you so much, Sharayu ma'am. Every time you used to motivate me, you used to tell me so many things that, and when you call me and when you told me that you are an inspiration, you have motivated so many of them, it feels so, so good, and I'm so blessed that I'm a part of this event. Thank you so much. Thank you, means a lot.
Okay, Namaskar. Can you sing?
Definitely, ma'am. Definitely, I would love to. I'll just sing four lines for you because there's a lot of noise in my background.
No problem.
Okay. सोच तुझे तो है सुभाव, सोच तुझे तो शाम है, मंजिलों पे अब तो मेरी एक ही तेरा नाम है, तेरी आग में ही जलती कोयले से हीरा बन के, खाबों से आगे चल के है तुझे बताना, तेरे वास्ते मेरा इश्क सूफियाना, मेरा इश्क सूफियाना, मेरा इश्क सूफियाना, तेरे वास्ते मेरा इश्क सूफियाना, मेरा इश्क सूफियाना, मेरा इश्क सूफियाना.
थैंक यू. Thank you, Namaste. It was wondrous. Indeed, you have left us so far.
Thank you.
We wish that you make a mark in your future venture and you reach great heights with flying colors. We all are proud of you. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, Alka ma'am. Indeed, the interaction was interesting, and I know all of us look up to our alumni. Now proceeding towards the vote of thanks. I quote, "The strength of the team is each individual member. The strength of each member is the team," unquote. Phil Jackson. We at Deeksharambh thank all the teachers, our alumni, the admin staff for the support and help. We thank our leader and motivator, dynamic and charismatic principal, Dr. Soman sir, our alluring vice principal, Dr. Tessie ma'am. I also extend my gratitude to our registrar, Gandhali ma'am, and the Deeksharambh committee head, Dr. Sharayu Bhakre ma'am. Never to forget our IT team of Nitin and Nazir, sir, our kakas and mamas, and thank you all, dear students, for a patient listening. Thank you and have a great day ahead. See you tomorrow at 11 a.m. Thank you.